Pushing data from one application to another is critical in today's business environment. It's extremely common for businesses to use different software applications that don't talk to each other. Webhooks can be an easy way to move data from one application to another without having to have any programming skills. Hi, I'm Zach Spader with Cornerstone Solutions. And in part one of this video series, I'm going to show you how to build an outgoing webhook from Zoho CRM. To create our outgoing webhook from CRM, we're going to go to the setup icon up in the top right-hand corner of the screen. And then I'm going to go to workflow rules under automation. I'm going to create a new rule. I'm going to base it on the leads module, and then I'm just going to call it outgoing webhook. I'm going to click next. We're just going to make this very simple. So I'm going to go ahead and choose record action, and then I'm going to fire the workflow on the creation of a lead. So I'll hit next. I'm going to apply this to all leads. Hit next again. And then you'll see in the instant actions window here, one of my options is webhook. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the webhook option. I'm going to create a new webhook. I can add a description in. Then you'll see here the method. There's a different options for what you can do with a webhook. And we're just going to use the post option today, but just to let you know, you can also pull information, put information, delete information by using these different methods here. Again, we're just pushing information from one application to the other, so I'm going to use the post method. Then all webhooks need a URL to notify. And so in part two of this video, I'll show you how to create the URL in the incoming webhook listener. But for this case today, I already have this created. And so I'm just going to copy and paste my URL in that we are sending this to. You can secure the webhook by using a connection. We're just going to use a general authorization type. There's also, you can get really complicated and have module parameters and custom parameters in the header of the webhook. Again, that's a little more complicated than what we're going to show you today. Today, I just want to send information over in the body of the webhook. So I'm going to come down here to the body section and we choose a type. We have two options here in our outgoing webhooks. We have form data and raw. I'm going to go ahead and choose form data. And then we have the ability to add in different parameters into the body of our webhook. And so the option that we're going to choose today is the module parameters. We want to be able to pull information from the module within CRM, but you can also add in custom parameters and user-defined formats, things like that as well if you want to get more complicated. In this case, we're just going to use the module parameters. So I'm just going to click add parameter. And just like in code, you're going to give the parameter a name. So it's just like assigning a name to a variable. So I'm going to push over three pieces of information, the first name, the last name, and the email address. So I'm going to give each one of them a name. So for first name, we're just going to type in F name. We're pulling from the leads module. And then the parameter value is just the first name here. So we're going to select first name from the list. Then I'm going to add two more here. So I'm going to do last name, L name. And again, select the last name, and then we're going to do email. So I'm going to do email and choose the email field. Okay, now we can click save and associate. Now our workflow is all done. It's very simple. It's just whenever a new lead is created, it's going to push the first name, the last name, and the email address through this webhook. So I'm going to click save here. The workflow rule is turned on. So I'm going to go to my leads module and I'm going to create a new lead. I'm going to make sure the lead includes those three pieces of data, the first name, the last name, and the email address. And then I'm going to go ahead and save this record. Just to back up for a second, what we did was we just triggered our workflow that sends our webhook off. Now, before you test your webhook, you want to make sure that the listener on the other end of the webhook is on and ready to receive a webhook. So I just wanted to mention that before you actually test, make sure that the listener on the other end is on and ready. Now we can check here in our timeline of our lead record, and we can see here that our webhook was sent successfully. And so this has been part one on sending a webhook, an outgoing webhook from Zoho CRM. And we can see here on our lead record that that webhook was sent successfully. In part two of the video, we'll talk about the incoming webhooks and how to set those up. And then we'll see in that video what the data looks like when it actually comes in through the incoming webhook. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.